people describe us as being the closest thing to the royal family that the vampires have.
I would say High Court.
The guiding light to everyone who's going to do our bidding.
The mafia of the vampire
world. We're kind of like the guy that you know at school who thinks he knows everything.
I'm really excited to get a chance to meet the Volturi in their home. This is our chance to go and see them in their element.
There's something delicious about a vampire and yet tragic at the same time.
It's sort of like giving your Hamlet, in a way, giving your vampire. There's been many depictions of vampires, and it's exciting and a challenge. My name's Michael Sheen, and I play Arrow. Stephanie describes him as having a kind of chaotic state of mind, so things keep changing, so you never quite know whether you're safe with him or not.
It's a bit detrimental to your personal health if you have expectations.
There is something quite sentimental about it. I get to pull someone's head off, but at the same time there's a gleefulness, a feminine, like a sort of Venus flytrap, and an enjoyment of things that's sort of soft. You can just lull people in, maternal, childlike, like a comfortable old grandfather, but who can suddenly then eat you. There's a kind of unhinged quality about him.
I'm quite insane.
Michael Sheen just has the personality down.
Remarkable!
He's hopefully not coming across as being this sort of sinister Dracula character.
La tua cantante.
There was a moment where we were doing a scene the other day and I suddenly thought, oh, I sound a bit like the Blue Meanie from the Yellow Submarine film.
They have met the requirements of the law.
And the Blue Meanie is talking like this. I thought, well, that's good. I found that really disturbing when I was a kid.
The blood appeals to you so much. It makes me thirsty.
Some of the stuff he was coming out with was pretty revolting.
I knew that. Where is she? It's an actress of infinite depth.
I spent most of last night trying to convince Stephanie she should write another book in this series all about Arrow now. And then we can make a film with that.
I love a happy ending.
But they are so rare.
Go now. And make your preparations.
My name is Christopher Heyerdahl, and I'm playing Marcus. He's the vampire that had the greatest love of all time, and lost the greatest love of all time.
Not without cause.
Marcus was courting, can I say? Courting with Arrow's sister.
He's being forced into staying with this group, which, of course, is the reason why the tragedy happens with his lover.
Arrow ends up destroying her. which made me laugh.
He has a fascinating ability. He can tell how any 1, 2, 3, 5, 10, 100 people are interrelating. It can come in handy in all sorts of ways. Anyone's thinking of treason, he can sniff them out. He's somewhat of a tragic figure that has to continue on with this band of ruffians.
Let us be done with this.
My name is Jamie Campbell Bower, and this is not my real hair. I play Caius. He is a member of the Volturi.
One of the big three, but not all of them have supernatural abilities. Caius, for example.
He doesn't. He doesn't have one.
And yet, he is so focused. Arrow knows you can absolutely count on him to see things through the end. He's kind of a sadist.
We do not offer second chances.
Whoa. I think he's pretty angry about the fact that he doesn't have a special ability. But it's kind of fun to be perpetually angry or pissed off. I hope people know that I'm not actually scowling at them because I hate them. I'm scowling at you because I have to. I'm acting. We're very lethargic, sitting in the Volturi chairs. He's me. I am Caius. And Caius is me.
Sister, they sent you out for two. Oh, man. I'm sorry about that. Messed up my line.
Arrow, Caius, and Marcus are in charge, and then they've got their minions. Jane kind of being the foremost.
Jane comes in, she's young, she's arrogant.
Jane is kind of the secret weapon. She looks kind of innocent, but really her power
will mess you up.
My friends are excited to get to see me be an evil character.
You're letting them go?
And seeing me with red eyes and be mean for a change is kind of interesting to them, I think.
Alec is one of the henchmen. I have the ability to cut off senses. The one thing I really want to do is walk down like Main Street with these puppies right here, with sunglasses on, but like take them off randomly.
I was fishing, Heidi.
Yes, they do look rather juicy.
My name is Charlie Beely and I play Dimitri. He is the protector of the Volturi. He is an expert tracker. He hones in on the tenor of your voice, and unless you kill him, you'll never get away from him. From the books, Dimitri is very elegant, stereotypical Italian. He's played rugby for 17 years and not styly Italian.
Sir, Volturi!
But this kind of matador came out of me. And I found myself dancing around stage like an idiot, during takes, between takes, then on camera. You know, Volturi are really cool. Dimitri is really, really cool.
Felix is one of the enforcers for the Volturi. He is very animalistically powerful in the aspect of being able to just tear apart other vampires.
We should take this conversation to a more appropriate venue.
Well, as you read the books, you'll obviously know that we coerce Edward to come back into Volturi chamber to be answerable to Arrow.
A little bit of a fight does break out.
Me and Marcus just sit back and watch the whole thing play out. Edward jumps in and gets zapped.
Sorry for killing you, Felix.
You didn't kick me.
Yes, I did.
There is a lot of touching. There's a lot of screaming.
Don't!
It's intense.
It's thrilling to be a part of and to sit back and watch it all take place.
Very fun to come to Vamp Camp and to get to be one of the vampires makes it even more fun.
Well, what's not fun about playing a vampire, really?
I just get to sit there and scowl at people all day.
I can only assume that everyone thinks the same way that I do. Everyone wants to be a vampire.
I don't know why playing a vampire is so much fun. Maybe I have a secret bad side to me that I don't know about that I'm getting to play out through Jane.
Goodbye, my young friend.